Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2 Blind. I'm the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari, back in, well, New Reno, Shark Club, second floor. These are the stairs to the third floor. Mrs. Bishop is in here. We have not messed with her, but we have gone and everything. Got all the stuff from the bookcases that we could. Engage in all the same dialogue in here and outside. Exact same. Yeah, I bought this from Jagged J, whatever his name is. I pursued the same exact same conversation options and traded the same stuff with him. So I don't know if we can get up here. I'm not sure if I asked them or not. I did. What do you want, hon? Make it quick. What's up those stairs? If you don't know, then you don't need to know. Now blow. I'm here to see Mr. Bishop. No, I know Mr. Bishop's schedule, and you ain't on it. He's expecting me. Tell him I'm here. I don't think I went this far. All right, hon, what's your name? I'll check with the boss. I'm Andrea King. The guard steps away for a moment, opens a panel on one of the walls, and whispers something. He waits for a minute, listens, then turns back to you. He doesn't know you. Piss off, hon. You're wasting our time. It's not a red option. Let me see him now. Boy, you're one stupid bitch, ain't you? Look, get out of here before you beat the rest of your brains out of you. Let me pass. Okay, I just earned myself a ticket to a world of hurt. Now, the option before that should have been red. I don't have enough action points. I don't have enough action points for anything. Yeah, now I die. Alright. Oh, I hate that. This guy gives something different. Expecting me. Okay. Now this is kind of cheating. But see, I wouldn't go try something, fail, then reload. The only reload I do is if I fail and end up dying. So you don't need my name. Just let me see him. Alright, I'm leaving. Alright, we'll be back, I hope, to get in here. Check out that stuff. Obviously ammo in there. So maybe we'll get a tip or something, I don't know. Oh, I forgot to talk to this guy. Didn't I? I guess I'm trying to do everything over, and I put off this guy, Jimmy? Jim? What's his name? Old Man McGee. No, Jimmy's the other guy. Yeah, I put off because when I was originally playing it, I passed by him. I remember going into this. Alrighty then. Okay, we're done. Then in here for now, anyway. The Shark Club. That's the comedian. My name's Easy Girl. What's yours? Huh. I'm Slutty Spice. I've heard that one somewhere before. Take a gamble on me, honey. Oh, drug dealer. I got Jet, Jet, and more Jet. Let's talk. What have you got? Jet? Huh. Alright, let's see. I just out of curiosity, I'm not selling this. 50. I will sell that. 40. Empty hypodermic. Yeah, I know what it is. Thank you. Yeah. We might need it for something. Who knows? Cattle prod. Yeah, I'll sell it. Oh, we went way up in price there. He's expensive. Is this? No, it's just booze. I don't want to sell the Molotov cocktail. Will he buy the cosmetics case? Yeah. It's worth like 25. That's funny. Yeah, I might hold on to that. These robes. I even tried using these at the previous episodes. Maybe I could get past those guys with the robes. Nope, didn't work. I'm gonna hold on to the cosmetics case. Because I have these fish. I also forgot I have these. I have extra sharpened spears. That'll do the ticket. That'll do it. Alright. How much does he owe me? Math. Well, 193 plus 39, 130, oh, 230 something. Oh wait, he doesn't have that much money. Put that back. 1083. Okay. 22. Okay, good. Don't have any money left. You can afford my fish. I was like, I hope I still have the sharpened one, yeah. Buy my boots. Yeah, I might need them to keep out of sludge. I never noticed that one before. An old pair of sturdy rubber work boots, they look durable enough to keep out sludge. At least for a while. So hold on to that. I don't think it could afford anything else that I'm selling. I actually don't have much that I am selling. So I'll just take his 10. Good. Almost 500. One of the Reno townsfolk. That bishop daughter is out of control. Well, where is she? Vault of the future. Another drug dealer. Looking to fly? You got chips? Talk to me. The other guy across the street got to me first. Switchblade. Yeah, I really don't have much more I'd be willing to sell. Well, these lighters, I guess. Why would he need more than one? He can't even afford to buy a lighter. It's 100. And that's too much. Oh, my fish. That's right. What else we got? So I have these two guns and the spear. I don't know. He doesn't have enough money to buy my stuff, and I don't have enough money to... I mean, I can just give him more money, but I don't want to. I want to save it to get... What's his name out of Klamath? One fish is 85. He doesn't have enough. No business today, Sporto. Unless I find some more crap. I know what you're looking for, friend, and I got it. All the jet you need. What is this? I cannot get there. Oh, is he inside? He says I can't get there. Okay, so that's a shark club. Salvatore's. The Golden Globes place. This place I can't get into. Maybe from the other side. This is a dead end. This is the jungle gym. Yeah, that's it then. Except I don't think I've been over here, have I? Look for a good time to go. The whimpers and touches ears. Hadouken. You make my Geiger counter tick. Oh god. X. Caravan wagon converted from the wrecked remains of an ancient automobile. I don't see anything to take around here. Okay. We've got two ways to go? Four ways? Where's this? No, that's out. So let's go east and see where we end up. Saving. East side. Train tracks. A broken toilet, half buried in the sand. Life's a pisser, then you die. There's a train tracks there. Destroyed tables. a desk. It doesn't even work. Okay. What is this place, Megotar? Bad luck, ill wind, not good times, not good times. Not talking about this place. I'm making bank. Oh, like a converted or destroyed church. Actually, doesn't look in that bad condition. Except for the boxes. One of Wright's sons. The town's great, except for the pimps and whores. One of the Reno townsfolk. Wright's daughters. Tried to quit, but... better take off. No offense, but Dad doesn't like tribals much. I'm watching you, so you watch what you do. Here? Okay, we'll both watch me then. There's a separate entrance, right? You see a tall young man with a mohawk. He's wearing a lot of chains and leather. Yeah? Who are you? I'm Chris. Chris Wright, of the family Wright. Glad you asked. Looking for a job. Is family Wright hiring? Well, I mean, the Wright family, my family, might have an opening. I ain't promising nothing, but go to the mansion south of here, find my brother Keith, and tell him I sent you. Name's Chris. Chris Wright. Thanks. Can I ask you some questions? Like what? No questions. Never mind. He's got a lot of sons and daughters, this guy. Don't you even think about causing any trouble. We Wrights outnumber you by a lot. Well, smart. You here to see Dad about business? Good luck. I don't think he's hiring any hands now. Oh, there's a Doggins. Oh, the last time I talked to a dog, it didn't turn out so well. So let's not. Just keep your distance. You got business, do it. Then get. Oh, I thought they were opening fire on me. Oh look, there's a staircase there. Alright, they're watching me, so I'm not gonna go into desks and stuff. Automobile traffic control device. Nothing good here, huh? Not time on my hands. Okay. That leads out. What's in here? Garbage. Oh, this is the other side of what I was looking at, right? I can actually look at this stuff now. I don't think I can access anything. You find no details worth mentioning about the wooden boxes. Table looks in really good condition. Yeah, there's nothing I can do anything with. All right. I want to be the metal insect next game. You're always the metal insect. The metal insect. Bang, bang. Look out. Here comes the metal insect. Got you. We're the right children. I can't get there. I'm getting there. Don't take my money. The child stops buzzing around and lifts up the pot to look at you. Oh, he has a pot on his head. What are you playing? Metal insects and soldiers. Looks at your equipment. Spots one of your pistols. Can I play with your gun? Give him an unloaded pistol. I'll give him my pistol. No. I might give him the good one. How do I know which pistol I'm going to be giving him? Nope. Metal insects? He glares at you. Come on, I know how to use guns like that. I'm in family right. Let me see it, please. That first option is funny. Forget it. Go play with your friends. I want to be the metal insect next game. These are all rocks. Alright, let me just check. Do I still have my money? Yep. That's good. These Wrights are all over here, please. You better not have brought any drugs. Most dad'll kill you. Then I'll kill you. So these guys are all over this place. Just keep your distance. You got business, do it. And get. You harm any Wright, and the family won't rest until your hide is rotting in Golgotha. Alright. But harming a Wright ain't wrong. Who's that? Children. The kid stops and looks at you. Hello there, little girl. Mommy and Daddy were talking to God again last night in bed. Huh. Really? What else? I have a vagina. Kyle's got the squirts. I made a poo-poo. I saw Mikey kissing Maury Mordino. Millicent's a big meanie. Daddy calls Mommy a baby factory. Poopy head. Mommy was crying the other day. I think it's because of what happened to my brother, Richie. Daddy'll whip us if we sneak out again. Mummy's down by the church again. You're it. Want to play tribals and slavers? Mommy's been really sad since my brother, Richie, died. Fascinating, kid. I never see Christopher anymore. Oh, is there no one in this one? That'd be great. Make sure there's not someone hiding. I can't get back there. No. Alright. Just in case, like, I get attacked and everyone kills me. Nice. That one's empty. A military-style bunk bed. Looks very uncomfortable. Also looks like you could bounce a quarter off of these sheets. Okay, well, I got a little. The woman jumps. Oh my, you gave me such a fright. She squints at you. Yes, yes. Somehow I have the funny feeling that if I say something like this, she'll respond positively. I noticed you humming to yourself and thought I would stop and speak to you a moment, ma'am. Beautiful weather we're having, isn't it? Awfully random thing to say. Why, yes. Yes, it is. She smiles. I'm Mrs. Ethel Wright, head of the Temperance Union here in New Reno. And who might you be? I don't have an option to tell her who I am yet. Temperance Union? Why, yes. She wags her finger at us. New Reno is a beautiful city. Oh, my. But, there is sin here, much of which can be traced back to the evils of alcohol, or as you tribesmen call it, pauses dramatically, fire water. Yeah, we primitives call it alcohol, too. She's rambling on. The Temperance Union was established to help people turn away from the poison of drink and turn towards more hard-working pursuits. Such as what? New Reno can't exist on gambling and alcohol and prostitution expected to survive. Oh no, not while Ethel Wright is at the helm. It won't work. No siree. I can't help but notice the irony. Ethyl alcohol. Who's all in your organization? She thinks. Well, good Father Tully for one. Father Tully? Oh yes, he's a spiritual leader of New Reno. He runs the only chapel in New Reno. You simply must speak to him. He's quite inspiring. Okay, maybe I will. So what does the Temperance Union do? The Temperance Union was established to help people turn away from the poison of drink and turn towards a more hard-working pursuit. Okay, how about... Okay. Taking a chance again. Nice. That's cool with you? Okay. I got leather armor. Are you kidding me? I cannot get there. Oh, I can't get to the other side of her. She's blocking my way. Ah, to work. Such pleasure in doing a task and doing it well. Such pleasure in finding free leather armor. AC went from 15 to 22. Now maybe I could survive that thing upstairs. I'm not sure, though. What do you want? Are they gonna attack? Stay away from there. You hear this? He died about business? Yeah, I saw that one. If you're looking for alcohol, the train station is the place to be. Okay. Get away from there. Alright. Where the hell is that woman? Ethel! Ethel! I don't know you. My dad don't know you. And if you don't start splaining, it ain't gonna matter. Who are you? I'm Keith Wright of the family Wright. Now you're gonna tell me what you're doing here? Telepathic abilities. Chris told me to stop by. I'm looking for work. Can you help me? Chris sent you, huh? That's right. He said you might have some work for me. Hold on. Knocks on the door behind him. Not telepathic. I did meet that guy Chris. That's what his name was. I forgot. Pa? He sticks his head in. There's some mumbling. Then he comes back and nods at the door. You can go in, but watch out. Dad's in a pissy mood. Thanks. Stay away from there. What do you want now? Hey, Keith, I ran into your mom. What about her? Has she gotten herself in trouble again? No, is that a common occurrence? Sometimes. She's always preaching and hollering about the evils of drink and gambling and damn near everything else. Causes quite a stir sometimes and gets Dad real upset. Does your mom have any idea what your family does? She don't know the half of it. She thinks Dad's all clean and above the board, but she ain't too bright to catch on to what he's doing. If she found that that's still beneath a train station, she'd raise Cain, she would. I see. Thanks, Keith. Huh. Wonder if they have the option to tell her now. Bring me my book. Orville. The Wright brothers. Yeah, I was wondering how far they were gonna go with the Wright stuff. Nice looking metal table. Hello there. Oh. This doesn't end well. Wrinkles cover this old man's face. It looks like any expression other than a scowl is foreign to him. Only a few brown hairs are left in his thick gray hair. Start talking, Tribal. Who are you and what do you want? I'm a simple traveler looking for work. No shit, he sneers. Well, pleased to meet you, simple traveler. Glad you stopped by. Damn neighborly of you. The sneer crumbles into a frown as he scopes you out. Looking for work and family right, huh? Yes, I... So happens my family is family right. Blood thicker than water and all. He scowls. What makes you think I need a piece of tribal ass like you and my family? I got enough whores to suck off of all of Northern Cali. Okay, I thought this was going to end badly. We got one option, though. Give me a test, then. Let me prove myself. He studies you for a moment. All right. Maybe you not being in the family could be a good thing. The scowl fades. You got children? Not to my knowledge. I think I'd remember. One of my sons, my boy Richard, passed away recently. Drug overdose. Jet. How can I help? I want to know what dealer gave that shit to Richard and forced him to take it. Every time I send my boys to find out, they turn up nothing. Maybe someone who ain't got right blood could get some answers. Will he barter? No. I'll take the job. He nods. All right, then. Now look. You find that son of a bitch who killed my boy. Don't you touch him. You just come back and tell me the dead man's name. His eyes blaze. I'll take care of it from there. Any leads? His eyes blaze. No. Everybody's too scared to talk. To a Wright, anyway. If I were you, I'd question some of the Reno drug pushers. See what they know. That jet came from somewhere. Any pushers you suspect? He frowns. Way I see it, it was probably a Mardino pusher. That goddamn family controls nearly all the jet in Reno. I'd scope out the Desperado, see what dealers hang around there. Find the person who gave him the jet. Don't hurt them. Just come back and tell you. Got it. Alright, I'm gonna save. Because he might kill me now. Oh, nice. I would love another 223 full metal, 223 gun, actually. And that's a hunting rifle. I guess he doesn't see me because his back's turned. Nice! Oh, I'm making out. Vault. We're gonna have to expand distribution if we're gonna stay in the Reno map. Oh, there's another one of those paintings. Yeah. It's like the same one we found in Klamath. It's like Elvis or something. Oh, I just robbed these guys blind. He doesn't want to talk about his brother Richard, obviously. Alright, so we got to question drug dealers. So obviously the Wrights own this place. So wait, is there a Wilbur then? We got an Orville. Those are the kids. I don't suppose I can get it. Is that the place that... Yeah, that's the junk place. Nothing out of the ordinary, it's a weird symbol. Where am I? Oh. Look at me! In leather armor for free. Loving it. What is that? Oh, it looks like there's somebody's legs back there. Getting dark. Alright, let's head back. Well, join me back next time. I guess we're going to check out the west side. Before I do that, I'm going to question some of those drug dealers that hang around outside the Desperado. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.